So we've had one teaser trailer for episode 9, that's it, and it occurred to me that we're probably going to get a full trailer at D23. I decided that I like to get my predictions out there before I have anything valuable to actually go off of because I like playing on hard mode, I guess. There are 25 items on a bingo card, so I will be presenting my predictions in a numbered list. In the interest of sportsmanship, I don't want to pick anything that people are super confident is going to happen, but first I need to fill my free space, so I want to pick something very uncontroversial that like people are pretty certain is going to happen. I'll just put Reylo. Okay, number 2, BB-8, new paint. We need a reason to release new droid merch. Everybody already has a BB-8. Everybody has an evil BB-8. Give me undercover BB-8. He's too distinctive. How will he go on an undercover mission with B-story character? He needs new paint, at least new painted highlights. I'm saying purple. I'm worried they won't do this because he's got that new droid friend, Dio. And frankly, that's no excuse not to have a disguised BB-8. Number 3, Poe dead Iran. I don't really think he'll die at this point, but he could. Maybe he will. He's the only one of the core buddies that I could actually see dying at this point, so I'll nominate him. And I've never liked Poe Dameron that much, so like, yeah, they can have him. And by they, I mean the Grim Reapers. Number 4, Finn lives. That's just an addition to the last one. Finn already had his growth moment in episode 8 and tried to make a heroic sacrifice and was prevented from doing so. It would be very redundant if he tried it again and succeeded. So yeah, I think he'll live. Number 5, 5? Yeah, 5 Anakin Force Ghost. I already said I didn't want to do the obvious ones, so I didn't want to put Luke Force Ghost on this list. Seems a little too telegraphed, especially after his line in episode 8 where he says, "I'll see you around in episode 9 when I return as a Force Ghost." So I thought I'd go for a wild card. In all honesty, I feel like an Obi-Wan Force Ghost feels a little more likely. But with all this stuff about family legacies in this trilogy, I thought that like maybe they would do Anakin, I don't know. I just decided to go big or go home. And his presence makes even more sense if we consider that this movie will be about Kylo Ren being redeemed. 6, somebody other than Kylo Ren puts on the helmet. I have no basis for this one, it's just something that occurred to me as a nifty idea. And it seems weird that he smashed it up and then decided to just put it back together and then put it back on his head. And after all that stuff he said about letting the past die. But if somebody in the First Order wanted to kill him and rule in his place, I have no idea who would want to do that. Just gonna stand there and watch me burn. That's alright, cause I like the way it hurts. Then that would maybe be a convenient way to go about that. Hey, maybe if you don't want your subordinates to murder and overthrow you, you shouldn't seize power with your face and voice completely disguised 95% of the time, so you're very easy to kill and impersonate. Alternatively, maybe a good guy character could wear his helmet as like a diversion or part of some plan. I don't know, it's just when you have a significant helmet kicking around, it seems like kind of a missed opportunity if you don't have some kind of helmet-related hijinks. Number 7, Leia lives. Yeah, I don't think she'll get killed off-screen or during the movie. Like, I don't think she'll speak or be around much in the movie, but I do think her character will be alive and giving orders from somewhere else. They can use archive footage or like a body double with the back of her head to show her in a final victory scene to just let us know that she's still around. It feels totally doable to me. Like, you see the back of a distant figure or like the back of her head as she waves or like hugs her son because he's getting redeemed. Number 8, Rey conjoined lightsabers. Since Rey fights with a big stick, everyone predicted she's going to have a saber staff like Darth Maul. Episode 8 ended with her lightsaber being broken in half, including the kyber crystal that's inside. Oh no, too bad Rey's not a character who spent her whole life rummaging through garbage and repurposing broken things, and it's not a metaphor. So having the kyber crystal in two pieces is a great excuse to make a double-ended weapon, but I'm calling it conjoined lightsabers because I think it'll still be able to detach into two halves and have two swords. The main reason I think that is I think it'd be really cool if there's a fight where she needs to like throw somebody a weapon and she breaks her own thing in half and you're like, whoa, what? You know, like when Kylo Ren is redeemed and for whatever reason he doesn't have his evil lightsaber and she has to symbolically throw him her good guy lightsaber or something like that. It would also be cool to see her toss it to a different character who's not even a Jedi, like Finn or Rose. Not Poe Dameron because I don't like him very much. Number 9, R.I.P. 3PO. C-3-R-I-P-O. C-3PO's had a good run, But it's time for him to die.
Actually, I think he'll make a heroic final stand and then appear to die and sacrifice himself, but then be repaired and be fine.
Kids' movies love to do that with their cowardly sidekick characters. It's both comedic and touching to see them stand up for their friends occasionally. 10, a flying character. As we know, multiple Disney parks are going to get Star Wars lands. Disney also loves to have nighttime fireworks spectaculars, the best part of which is when they hoist some kind of flying character on a zip line over the castle. Usually it's Tinkerbell, but one time it was Dumbo, and they've even done Nemo before. What Star Wars is really missing right now is some kind of droid or lovable alien that can hoist over the castle in a Star Wars fireworks show. Our flying Star Wars characters are kind of limited. We have Boba Fett, but he's a big man, so he might not be good for wire work. I would say a Porg, but I don't think they're known to be proficient flyers. And what does that leave us with? Watto? You gonna make Watto the centerpiece of a fireworks spectacular? So we need some cute, tiny flying creature that's easily rendered in mascot suit or puppet form. Number 11, back to Jakku. This is another one I have no basis for. It just seems like a thing you do in trilogies. You have a character who's been away from their tiny life and changed so much, and then it's fun near the end to have a scene where they go back and like reflect on their humble beginnings and how far they've come. We see Rey in a desert in the trailer, but that rock work did not look like Jakku, so I'm not thinking that scene. I'm just saying in general, like a short scene or some kind of epilogue after the fighting has happened, I don't know. Number 12, Slug is friend. There's that slug monster thing on the poster, and I think it's pretty cute, and I don't have any substantial guesses about it, but I hope that it is friend and not foe. Number 13, big Rose reveal. So episode 7 ended with Finn in a coma and his health ambiguous. I had kind of assumed that that meant in episode 8, we just wouldn't really see Finn for a lot of the movie, and like his friends would be off on new missions and not really know what his deal was or how he was doing. And then we'd have a later scene of the characters in peril, and suddenly they're rescued by like someone from off screen. And you're like, who's here? Who's their mysterious rescuer? And then it cuts to it and it's Finn, he's okay. And like the audience applauds. Cause Finn's back. That didn't happen, but episode 8 ended with Rose in a coma and her health ambiguous. So basically this bingo square is that, but with Rose. We have a time jump with this movie, so it wouldn't be a surprise to her friends, but it would be a surprise to the audience, and it's like her big entrance. Number 14, somebody has a backpack. Star Wars costumes can be a mixed bag from movie to movie. Literally. Sometimes a character is shown in at least one scene utilizing some kind of space backpack, and sometimes they're not. I'm going to guess in this movie, we'll see the former. For it to count, the backpacked character needs to have dialogue. They're going on a team adventure in this movie, like some kind of field trip, so I think my odds for seeing this are pretty good. If I was going to have a character carry everybody's stuff in a backpack, I would have it be Poe, but that's just me. Number 15. The Knights of Rest in Peace. The Knights of Ren have to go. They appear to be hanging around on the poster, which means they have not been written out, but with this being the last movie, I just don't think there's ample time to like handle them as characters, so they have to die. I see this going down one of two ways. One, there's that shot in the teaser of Kylo Ren fighting alongside stormtroopers in a forest and taking down some kind of armored opponent. Like in the part that we see, he's working with them, but for how long? It's possible that there's a scene where Kylo Ren is lured out on some kind of first order mission so that he can be quietly executed in a forest by somebody working for Hux. Sorry, I mean, whoever wants to overthrow him. Just gonna stay. I think the Knights of Ren could be used as canaries in the coal mine. Maybe they're all out on a mission together, and then the stormtroopers and First Order troops start trying to execute all of them, Order 66 style. They all get taken out, and Kylo Ren sees it happening, which gives him an opportunity to fight back, and he narrowly escapes, but they're all dead. Number 2, the Knights of Ren themselves, being Darksiders and as such maybe not loyal, are the ones trying to assassinate Kylo Ren. It's like 5 against 1. Kylo Ren is forced to fight them all. He either trounces them all, and it's just kind of a warning shot to him and kind of just a cool, entertaining early movie fight scene,
Or it's like difficult and he barely escapes with his life. That could also be what Kylo Ren's doing in that one promotional still, is like barely escaping with his life. That's why he looks all dirty and unhappy. Or maybe that's just what his hygiene is like right now. Then they could remain as opponents that have the Force and have to be taken out later as like a final boss or something. I'm actually imagining either of these two scenarios happening relatively early in the movie, but that's just some unfounded scenario spinning. This bingo square is just the Knights of Ren die. That's all I had to say. Number 16, Kylo lives. Yeah, I said it. Number 17, the Millennium Falcon explodes. I think this ship is going out in a blaze of glory. It's the last movie, so it's time. I feel like it's going to be destroyed in some kind of heroic and significant way. Like it'll be used as bait to take out a bunch of bad guys. Maybe even Lando himself will rig it to explode in a touching scene demonstrating his commitment to the Resistance and his selflessness compared to when we first met him. I was really torn on this initially because they've just built a huge life-size Millennium Falcon to put in Star Wars Land. They have this whole ride where you're flying it, and I was like, would that be weird if canonically it got exploded? And then I was like, well, you can meet Gaston at Disney World, and he's not zombie Gaston who fell to his death. You could even get photos and autographs with Judge Claude Frollo, who is both dead and not a man who would be likely to give autographs. I think we can just kind of play with the timeline on this one. I was a little tempted to put Chewbacca dying in this spot, but like, he sells a lot of plush dolls, and like, they're not gonna kill Chewbacca and blow up the Millennium Falcon, and they're also unlikely to kill Han and kill Chewbacca, so I'm gonna leave him alone. Number 18, spherical drink cameo. Speaking of Star Wars Land, now I don't think for one second that anyone has the audacity to put a straight up Coca-Cola bottle in a Star Wars movie, but I could see a generic, non-labeled or generically labeled drink product that is in a round little bottle like the drinks in Star Wars Land. Frankly, I'm rooting for it because it doesn't make canonical sense to take a drink from a thermal detonator, and I refuse to believe that's what these are. Number 19, loss of limb. I don't really care anymore who loses a limb or which limb they lose. I guess if I could pick, it would be Kylo. An arm is traditional for his family, but a leg would be a nice shakeup, but I understand why it's always arms. They never have them lose a leg because of the impracticality of having someone wounded that you need to get off of like a collapsing Star Destroyer, and they can't walk because they're missing a whole leg. So yeah, if anything, I would predict an arm, but I'm down to be surprised. Number 20, I'll like it. If you think I can't put this on my own personal bingo card, just see yourself out right now. Man, I really hope I can cross this one off. I don't care if I think it's perfect because I haven't thought that about either of the other two. Every family movie ever made has to have what I call the popcorn refill scene, which is like the Wrath Tars in episode 7 or the Canto Bite chase scene in episode 8. It's usually a chase scene. It's very noisy. There's not a lot of plot furthering. And then I go get a refill of my collectible tin of popcorn. I hate scenes like that. I think they make movies that are really good ultimately imperfect, and I always skip them when I rewatch, but I think the studio mandates them or something. But my point is that all told, I have liked the other two movies. I've really liked them, and I've watched them many times. Some would say a shameful number of times. So I really, really, really hope that I like this one. I didn't feel quite as nervous going into episode 8 because, like, it's the middle one, so the positions that it leaves all the characters in aren't conclusive unless somebody dies. But this is the very last one, so if I'm dissatisfied with any major character's plot, that's just a bummer, and that's what I'm gonna go out on. I'll just like feel really disappointed every time I think of the series as a whole, and then like a week will pass and I'll get over it and I'll just rewatch the other ones that I liked again. So anyway, I'm just going to be optimistic and predict on my bingo card that I will like it, and let's all hope for a blackout, okay? Number 21, Batuu cameo. I've mentioned brand synergy with the theme parks a couple times now, but I think we'll see some kind of overt reference to the planet Batuu, which is the setting of Star Wars Land, in the next movie, so it's officially part of like the trilogy. Just some kind of overt reference to the planet Batuu or one of its inhabitants. I don't think we'll actually go to Batuu or see it. That feels like too much, but you know, a dialogue nod to them. Like maybe in a control room, somebody will mention it in a strategy meeting. I'm talking that level. Number 22, Skywalker equals the new Jedi Order. Firstly, I think the Skywalker that's rising in the title is Kylo Ren. I think he's going to be redeemed, so he's going to rise from the dark side. Whatever. You know, in some kind of redemption arc. But I also believe that Rey will end up establishing a new, basically a new Jedi Order. It just won't be called Jedi. And they could call it Skywalker to, like, honor Luke's memory. It'll be the same. It just won't have all the weird rules and, like, the council. It won't be, like, in an office building in a city. It'll be, like, what people wanted Jedi to be before the prequels got made. I kind of hesitated to put this one on there because I think it's, like, a very popular fan theory. I'm far from the only person to say this, but like I needed 25 things, so whatever. I'll just put it on the record that I think so too. Also, for the record, I don't love this. I think that Jedi is a cool word that's not made from other words and is just like a nice concise phrase for your made up space wizards, and Skywalker is almost dorkily on the nose. But maybe the path of teaching can be called Skywalker, and then please, we'll still call them Jedi. Please. I don't know. Anyway, I don't have to like it to predict it, so that's my prediction. Number 23, Rey Nobody. Still. It feels so weird to even have to say this, to like re-predict the thing that I already predicted and was already right about, and like it was all settled, but now it's back. But anyway, I don't believe they're going to retcon that Rey's parents are drunken nobodies. I don't think Kylo Ren was lying or Rey was mistaken or whatever people have been telling themselves to discredit a thing that was literally just told to us in the last movie. I think it's thematically important that Rey comes from nowhere as opposed to her antagonist who comes from a long legacy. I think the fan conspiracy theory that Rian Johnson just like wrote whatever he felt like and everybody else was helpless to stop him and they were all angry and hated it is extremely weird and like shows a total misunderstanding for how large movies get made. I really thought episode 8 would put an end to the Rey's parentage debates by, you know, having the characters outright tell us about her parents and then having like Kylo say it and Rey confirm it and agree with him and not seem surprised by the information or like it was untrue in any way. I'd be massively disappointed if they undid this. Unless they made Rey a Palpatine, which that would be extremely stupid, but it would be in a way that I would enjoy, so it would be fine. Oh, one thing I will say is I do think it's possible that they were mistaken about Rey's parents being dead, like maybe she heard they were dead and Kylo's getting his information from her memories, so it would make sense that he would also be mistaken, but like maybe one or both of them is still alive and Rey will have some kind of cathartic confrontation with one of them. Rey seemed very convinced they were going to come back for her, which could have been entirely self-delusion, but it could also be that she heard they had died and refused to believe it, and maybe that was within good reason. Maybe they were actually alive, but they were also drunks and did leave her behind and like weren't good people. They just are still alive now. I still think they are not legacy characters and were filthy junk traders who sold her off for drinking money, but it's possible they'll reveal that her mother is alive and is like the new Carrie Russell character. I still don't think if they did this that her mom would be force sensitive or related to anybody. Maybe it would just be used to like contrast her versus Kylo Ren, where she can like forgive her mom for her shortcomings. Again, I don't love this. It seems kind of unnecessary. I think there are already a bunch of cool character dynamics to play with, and you don't need to throw a bunch more into the mix, but we already know that we are getting new characters, so like, yeah, maybe that's what they're doing with them. Number 24, Palpageist. I think I just delight in making my bingo card totally unintelligible to anyone but me. So basically, I felt like I needed something, anything on my card that was a Palpatine prediction. You hear his evil laugh in the trailer implying he's coming back. I want to have faith that episode 9 won't be stupid. And I've been racking my brain for non-stupid reasons that you could bring Palpatine back into the mix. And there aren't a lot. Basically, the only non-stupid routes would be that he's back in the form of a holocron, or a ghost. I might be misremembering, but I believe there's a precedent in the EU for Sith to come back as ghosts, but they're a little bit different than the Force ghosts we see from Jedi. Unlike Force ghosts, which can manifest anywhere and are kind of like angels watching over everything, I believe Sith ghosts are more like Earth ghosts in that they are location locked. They appear in a place that was either significant to them or is the place that they died, and they're just like traditional scary ghosts. I'm just wildly guessing here, but perhaps in the time between the movies, Rey has studied all of the Jedi texts and she has learned as much as she can from them. But because she's not an old Jedi, she's a cool new fun Jedi, she decides that she needs balance and she also needs to learn some of the ways of the Sith. Maybe to set this up, she loses some early movie conflict against the Knights of Ren and or Kylo and she's like, my training is incomplete, I need balance. And so she goes to get a lesson from the Emperor's evil ghost. As you do. This sounds so zany, but I kind of love it, right? So she decides to go to the ruins of the Death Star on like a fun ghost adventures type mission. Her friends all go along like for moral support, you know? Then there's this fun scene where she talks to Ghost Palpatine and has to like convince him to help her because I assume he doesn't just want to help her for no reason. Maybe after an initial like back and forth between them, it cuts back to where her friends are waiting for her. And she comes out and she's like, okay, I learned what I came here to learn. And it's left kind of vague, like maybe she means philosophically or whatever. And then in the big final fight, Rey gets disarmed and you're like, oh no, what's she gonna do? She doesn't have her lightsaber. And then she just uses force lightning and you're like, oh my God, that's what she learned from Palpatine. And that's what she can do now. She can do force lightning out of her hands. Like an evil warlock. Okay, this idea is actually really exciting to me. I hope it's not something I hate instead. Alternatively, if Palpatine is alive, I would like to see him thrown off another balcony. Okay, I'm at number 25. I just need one more thing for my bingo card. Well, shoot, I don't really have any other predictions. Oh, I guess Kylo Ren might get redeemed? You know, maybe. I really tried to have some kind of prediction for the woman in the Vanity Fair article that's riding the horse warthog, and I have nothing. I sort of wonder if she'll be part of that aforementioned popcorn refill action scene. Either way, I'm glad to see this warthog horse. That's pretty nice. If I had my way, every new piece of Star Wars media would have some kind of horse avatar. And speaking of horses, remember that if you doubt even a single one of my predictions, I called that episode 8 was gonna have an alien horse race, sight unseen. That's all there is to say about that.